जय हिंद टू ऑल। दिस इज आकांक्षा शुक्ला फ्रॉम इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट। करेंटली और टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ वेब टेक्नोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज डॉक्यूमेंट टाइप डेफिनेशन। बिफोर मूविंग ऑन टू दिस टॉपिक, आई वुड लाइक टू जस्ट गिव अ ओवरव्यू ऑफ एक्सएमएल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, because this topic document type definition is basically used to structure the XML documents. So the XML documents are the full form of XML is extensible markup language, and basically the XML is used to provide the structure for the document. So this technology or this technique, document type definition, it describes the structure of XML document in the form of tree structure, and also it tells about what is the root element. Basically what happens in tree like structure, we have a root node, we have a child nodes, we have a parent nodes. So DTD describes the tree structure of an XML document and also describe the contents about its data. As DTD is a set of or it, you can say that it is this method, this technique is a set of markup affirmations that actually defines the types of documents for the HTML family. What is the full form of HTML family, or what we abbreviation is HTML, and what is the full form of HTML is standard generalized markup language. So HTML, XML, HTML, GML, these all are the all comes under the HTML family documentation. And if I'm talking about DTD, then it can be declared inside an XML document as an inline, or it can be declared outside the XML document in the form of external recommendation. It also able to determine that in how many times a particular node should appear and how their child nodes are ordered in a particular structuring of the XML document. Means if you are going to make the DTD for XML document, then with the help of that DTD, you can easily identify that how many times a particular node is appearing in the particular document, in the particular structure of in the particular DTD, and how their child's nodes are associated or how their child nodes are ordered. You can easily identify with the help of or with the sync of DTD. Basically there are two kinds of data types which we used in DTD. The two kinds are PC data and C data. The full form of PC data is parsed character data, and C data stands for character data. So whenever we use C data type, then it means that the particular data will not be further parsed by the document. And PC data means that particular that element will contain those kind of data that will be further parsed. So what do you mean by parsing? Now question arises that what is parsing? So basically the parsing is a technique in which or it provides the ability to the user application through which it can act as an interface through which for the user applications to interact with the things happening over the system. So PC data is the parsed character data, C data is character data not usually parsed or not be able to parse further, but the element which contains the data just like PC data can be further parsed. Parsed means the ability to read or to access the document, or it provides an interface for the user applications to interact or to access the documents which are available. Now the first one is internal DTD declaration. Here the tree is declared here, in which the root node is address, and the further nodes of that root node is name, email, phone, birthday. The name node will further divided into two parts, first name and last name. Email and phone number has only one, or you can say that has only unique entries that will not be further decomposed or divided further. So there you can see that there will be no further division of email and phone. In birthday node we have further three divisions. So this is a tree like structure. Now what is the DTD code for that particular structure? So here I am going to discuss about the internal DTD declaration. So what happens when the DTD is declared inside the XML file, then it must be wrapped inside the doc type definition, which is the first line of your code. Okay, now here the first line states that we are using the XML version 1. Now what happens whenever we are going to write the internal DTD or we are going to write the DTD declaration program, then first of all what you have to write, you have to write the doc type, and after that you will write the root node of the tree. So here the root node of the tree is address. So what we have written, doc type, the name of the root element, that is address. Now after that we open the big bracket, and now we are going to write each and every element which we are able to see in this tree structure. So after declaring the root node, that is address, now we are going to address the further elements of that root node. So in the next line what we write element, then root node, that is address. Now whatever the elements of that particular root node we write here, so name, email, phone and birthday, these four are the elements of root node address. So I have written all the elements of that particular root node. Now what we do next, now after declaring all the elements, we take each and every element, and if there will be further division of that particular element, we will write the name of that also. So now from here, what is the first element? Name. So what we write? Element, first element is name. Now we can see in the tree structure that name will further divided into the two parts, first and last. So what we have written? First comma last. Okay, now again, what element first contain? It contains PC data, and again the last contains the PC data. PC data, I had already told that PC data stands for past character data, means this element contains the data which can be further passed. Okay, now so we can see that in this tree, if we are moving from address to name, then this part is completed fully. Now come to next part, that is email. So next element is next one is a element, then next part is email. Now again email is not further divided, so we declared here only the data type of email, that is PC data only. Again next element phone, so the next element is phone, and also it is not further divided, phone is single, it has not been further divided, so I declare the data type for that element also here only. The next element is the birthday, so the element birthday, here we can see from the tree that it has further division into three parts, that is year, month and day. So I had mentioned here these three things, and after that element year, element month and element day, I had passed to all these three elements the data type, that is PC data. To simply what you have to do in when we are going to declare or when we are going to program the internal DTD, then what we have to do, we have to simply first of all we have to write the code, just like in whatever the version of XML you are using. After that you have to start from the root element of the tree. Now, so in this example the root is address. For example, if you are taking if you are having another example, suppose just like the student, the root node is student, and further the divisions of this is just like CSE student, IT student, mechanical student, civil student. So for this given example the code will not change. Here address will be replaced by the student only. And further what you have to write here, in place of name, you will write CSE, then IT, then mechanical, then civil, and if these are further divided, then as per this syntax or as per this syntax of a given example, you can have a code for another example also. If this thing is very much clear to all, then that can be further proceeded for another examples also. So simply what you have to do, you have to first of all address the root node, then with the use of the name of that root node only, you will write all the names of the elements, and later on you have to pick up one by one each element and further processed the further divisions of that particular element. If no any division of that element is seen by the tree, then you have to simply pass the data type for that element only. Just like in the given example, if the email is not further divided, then I had passed the data type PC data to that particular element. Okay, so this is internal DTD declaration. And also now, this is the simply the declaration of the DTD. Now the XML part of the previous example is, first the root node is address. Inside the address we have four elements: name, email, phone and birthday. So the first one is name. So we have I had here opened the name tag, and then it has further divided into two parts, first and last. So inside the first name we had passed the value Rohit, and in the last part we have passed the value Sharma. Now the name tag is closed here. Okay, then the next one is, the next element is email. So open email tag and then pass the value for the email, and then after that close the email tag. Next element is phone. So open the phone tag, put the or insert the value for that particular element, and then close the phone tag also. Now next tag is birthday tag. It has three values: year, month and day. So open the corresponding or respective tags and then pass the values, and then further close that respective tags here only. And at last birthday tag will be closed, and finally the root element will be closed here, that is the address node. Now what is the external DTD declaration? I had given the view of internal DTD. Now this is the example for external DTD. When the DTD is declared in an external file, okay, not inside the XML document, if it is declared as an external file, then it will be considered as an external DTD declaration. So what happens here, just like in the previous example, what we have seen that the root elements or the total DTD part is declared here only, and after that I had written the XML part. Now in external DTD what happens? First of all, pass the XML version value, and after that you have to pass the reference for external DTD, which you have to type or which you have to write externally, not inside the XML document, just like in the internal DTD, that DTD will be followed by the XML document only in the internal DTD. But in the external DTD, you have to write the DTD part externally, just like for example, here is the file name as node.dtd. So in this DTD part, what is the code? First of all, first element is element node. Means in this, if you are going to form the tree structure of that particular DTD, then node is the root node. It is further divided into four elements. Okay, four parts. So two from heading and body. These are the four elements. In this part the tree is not given, just like in the internal DTD a tree is given, and as per the given tree structure I am going to define the internal DTD declaration. Basically what happens here, I am writing this code, and as per this code, this tree will be formed, because what I had told that DTD declares the XML documents in a tree form structure. So this is the input, and that will be the output only. Okay. Now, in this example, in this external DTD, output is not given. So as per this documentation, I am defining the tree structure of that particular DTD. Okay. So as per the code of external DTD, here the root node is node, and that will be further divided into four main elements, two from heading and body. Now next part is first element is two. So it as I had told that if that particular element will not be further divided, then at that point only we have to pass the data type of that particular element. So I had passed the PC data to that particular element 2. It means it is not further divided. Next element is from. It is also not further divided. So PC data type is declared here for from element also. Now next one is heading. It is also not further divided. So data type PC data is passed for that element also. Next element is body, which is also not further divided. So I had passed the data type PC data to this. So this is the code for DTD only. Okay. Now save this code with node.dtd. Now what happens when we write the XML part, then in the XML part, after writing the XML version, what you have to write, you have to take reference of this DTD in the second line of XML document. Just like in the given example, doc type, node, system, this is the syntax. Okay. That part will be always written in capital letter, and after that you have to pass the name of that particular DTD which you are going to refer in this particular XML document. Okay. Now the next part is XML document part. So as per this tree structure, what is the root node? Node. So you have to open the node tag. Inside the node tag, we have four elements, two from heading and body. So respectively, you have to open each and every tag and pass the values, and correspondingly you have to close that particular tags. Okay. After that, finally the node tag, which is the root node, will be closed here only. So to top from journey, heading is reminder, and body part contains the textual data, that is don't forget me this weekend. So as per this external DTD, the basic advantage basic advantage of external DTD over the internal DTD is that in this external DTD we can have any kind of document, or we can refer any kind of DTD or any kind of document which is already written here. So we can have reference for any kind of documents or any kind of DTDs which had already been declared. So as per the requirement of the XML documentation, we can have reference for other also. But what happens inside the internal DTD, the DTD part and the XML part both are merged. We can say that both are merged. So we can have not the option of having references for other DTDs. The one which is written inside the XML document can be taken as only. Okay. So this is the basic difference, or this is the coding part, or this is the structuring part of the DTD, internal or external DTD. Now, the next part is what are the basic building blocks of XML documents for which we are going to structuring the documents using the internal or external DTDs. So from a DTD point of view, if you are having a DTD point of view, then what we have seen that a particular XML documents are made up by the following building blocks. So just like in the code of DTD declaration, we had already discussed these words. First one is elements, then second is attributes, then entities, then PC data, then C data. So first one is elements. What are the elements? These are the main building blocks of both the XML and HTML documents. Without the elements, I think the XML or HTML documents are incomplete. Okay, so in DTD, XML elements are declared with the following syntax, which I had already show you that this is the code. This is the element, the syntax of declaring the element. So in the DTD, the declaration for any element is this element, then element name, and then what is the category of that particular element. So element is a main building block, or it is the primary part of the XML or HTML document. Without the element, XML and HTML elements or documents are incomplete. Or okay, next is attributes. So basically, attributes provides the extra information about the elements. So whatever the data comes under the attributes, it provides the additional information for a particular elements also. Okay, just like in this example, name. So first and last are its attributes, okay, which are giving the extra information about the name, that a name is also having or is including the first part, or the just like some names also contains the middle part also. So attributes simply used to provide the additional or extra information about the elements. Now what are the entities? Just like some characters have a special meaning in XML also, like less than sign, that defines the start of an XML tag. So whatever we are going to write in this start and start or end tag, XML end tag, then that part is known as the entities. Okay, so which things or which characters have a special meaning in XML, we should pass these things in a less than sign or in the XML tags also, and that part will be considered as a entity part. Next is PC data. PC data means parsed character data. And if you are thinking about a character data as the text which is found between the start and end the tag of an XML element, then that particular part can be further parsed or can be considered as a PC data also. Now if you are going to declare the data type, that is PC data, for a particular element, then this text will be examined by the parsers for more entities or for more markups, because we had declared this element as a PC data. So the parsers will consider that particular element as a parsed character data, and they will examine that data, that further it will be parsed, or if that data or if that text contain any more markups or any entities also. So if you are going to examine the PC data, then it will check that tags inside the text will be treated as the markups, and entities will further be expanded also, because it will be considered as a PC data also. So whenever the parsed character data, so what is the basically rules for parsed character data is that parsed character data should not contain any ampersand, less than or greater than characters. These need to be represented by the and amp and it and gt entities respectively. Means these are the some syntax or these are the some rules which should be followed by the parsed data, parsed character data. Okay, so it should not be represented by these terms only if that particular data is a parsed character data. Now C data means simply a character data which is not be further parsed by a parsers. So if there will be tags inside the text, then it will be not, if we are going to return or if we are going to declare that particular tag as a character data, then whatever the tags inside that text will not be treated as a markups, and that entities will not be further expanded. Okay, so this is the basic difference between PC data and C data, that parsed character data, in parsed character data, the tags inside the text will be treated as a markups and the entities will be expanded further. But if the C data, if C character data is, character data type is used, then whatever the text will be written inside the tags, then it will not be treated as a markup and it will not be expanded further. Now, the next part is XML schema. बेसिकली एक्सएमएल स्कीमा इज अ डेटा, और एक्सएमएल स्कीमा इज सिंपली अ वैलिडेशन ऑफ एक्सएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट, एक्सएमएल डेटा पार्ट. सो द एक्सएमएल स्कीमा डेफिनेशन इज यूज टू डिस्क्राइब और वैलिडेट द स्ट्रक्चर्स. ओके, इट डिफाइंस द एंटिटीज, एट्रीब्यूट्स एंड डेटा टाइप्स ऑल्सो. स्कीमा एलिमेंट्स ऑल्सो सपोर्ट द नेम स्पेसेज ऑल्सो. इट इज जस्ट लाइक सिमिलर टू अ डेटा बेस स्कीमा. वी हैव नोन टू डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. इन डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम यू हैड फेमिलियर विद द डेटाबेस स्कीमाज. सो एक्सएमएल स्कीमा इज सिमिलर टू डैट स्कीमा ओनली विच डिस्क्राइब्स द डेटा इन अ डेटा बेस ओनली. ओके, सो यू नीड टू डिक्लेयर स्कीमा इन योर एक्सएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट. दिस इज द सिंटैक्स ऑफ पर्टिकुलर व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू डिक्लेयर द एक्सएमएल स्कीमा इन अ एक्सएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट. सो दिस इज द कोडिंग पार्ट इन विच यू हैव टू डिक्लेयर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू डिक्लेयर द वर्जन ऑफ एक्सएमएल. देन इनकोडिंग पार्ट UTF-8 और द अनदर इनकोडिंग इज UTF-16. सो बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट बाय डिफॉल्ट वी मोस्टली यूज द UTF-8 only. Okay, then you have to write the XML name spaces, schema XML name spaces. XML NS means XML name spaces. Then what is the element name, that is contact, and the complex type XML schemas or sequence and the name. And these are the some syntaxes which we have to use in the XML schemas. Okay, after that you have to close the further tags. As per these tags are opened, this will be correspondingly closed also. Okay, it supports XML schema, support the data types. So it is easier to describe the allowable document content. It is also easy to validate the correctness of data. If you are using the XML schema, then it is easy to validate the data correctness. It is easier to define the data facets, means if there will be any restrictions on the data, then it will be easy to define that. And to data, it is easier to define the data patterns and data formats. And also if you want to convert data between different data types, then it will become easy if you are using XML schema only. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.